What happened in Bomas was very unfortunate. I did not speak about it yesterday when we had the press conference with my family, because nilikuwa na kizunguzungu ya medication na madawa. But I have an injury at the back of the head and an injury on the neck because a sharp point of a chair hit me on the neck. And I also have another injury kwa mguu. But by the grace of God, I'm alive. Today I'm feeling better. Yesterday I think I was under, you know, a lot of medication, so I got dizzy. Painkillers, but and even antibiotics. But today I'm better. Chenye ilifanyika Bomas was very unfortunate, and it happened in the full glare of national TV. The people incited it and leaders holding state office. The Member of Parliament for Ruaraka, Honorable TJ Kajwang, the Honorable Member of Parliament for, or the Dishonorable Member of Parliament for Dagoretti North, Beatrice Elachi, the Dishonorable Member of Parliament for Makadara, Georgia Ladwa, and these are members of Parliament of ODM. So I don't know whether this is ODM's way of doing things. And ODM has been supported. ODM has been supported by Kenyans for a long time. I don't think whether this is how they should pay back for the support they've received. And ODM has been very violent, even in other occasions. I even witnessed a press conference where the Honorable Kalonzo Musyoka was supposed to address a press conference, and ODM goons walked in and chased away Kalonzo Musyoka. So I don't know whether they believe to be the only ones capable of violence. I don't know whether they believe that, or that they believe they are the kings of violence and nobody can beat them when it comes to violence, or can be more violent than them. But all I can tell them is that revenge belongs to God. And for me, I will not lose sight of my mission to turn around and start planning revenge against them. I'll stay focused on my mission, and the Kenyan people are going to avenge whatever they did and that they've done to many other people. I'm sure I'm not the only one who's been violently attacked by ODM trying to kill. You see, when you throw more than 50-30 chairs at someone, you don't intend to warn them. That's not a warning. You actually intend to kill them, because kitupia mtu kiti ya chuma kwa kichwa viti zaidi ya 30, unataka kumuua. Kwa hivyo yule MCA ambaye alikuwa amevaa koti ya pink kwa kamera na kwa video anaitwa Ringo, na hao vijana ambao wanatembea na Joja Ladwa na wanatembea na Beatrice Elachi, na wengine wao wanatembea na Honorable TJ Kajwang, mulifanya kitendo ya unyama, lakini pia kitendo ya aibu kubwa. Muliaibisha hiyo chama yenu na muliaibisha kabila yenu, kwa sababu sisi kama Wakenya hatutaki kuanza kupigana kikabila na kusema hii kabila imefanyia kabila yetu hii. As Kenya, we want to be one united country, and our problems as Kenyans are common. Shida zetu, hata hao wenye walikuwa wananipiga, si ati wao watafaidika na social health insurance, your SHIF. Si ati wao wako sawa, ati watoto wao wakipita waende university, funding model itawafavor. Labda itafavor viongozi, lakini not the goons. The goons, hata wao wananunua vitu kwa maduka hapa Kenya na hapa Nairobi. They know how expensive things have become. Wanalipa rent hapa Nairobi, wanajua vile rent imekuwa expensive. Wanajua vile kuna insecurity kwa communities. Wanajua vile corruption imetuumiza na imeharibu nchi yetu. Na pesa wanalipwa hata sio ya maana, ni pesa kidogo sana, ambayo iwezi kubadilisha maisha yao. Lakini kama uchumi yetu ingekuwa vizuri, they would not be even a goon for any politician. They would be doing their businesses, or they would be employed somewhere. So what they did was criminal. I'm surprised that the police have not done anything about it. The director of criminal investigation has not done anything about it. The inspector general of police has not done anything about it. And I don't think they have a plan of doing anything. The police service wamenyamaza. Na DCI wamenyamaza. Meaning they silently approve whatever happened. I think polisi wanajaribu kutuambia kwamba mtu yote ambaye anapinga serikali, if you are attacked and injured or killed, that's okay. That's okay. Wale watu ambao wao wanataka kudefend ni wenye wako pande ya serikali ama wenye wana support hii serikali ya ufisadi. Hivyo ndivyo polisi wanatuonyesha. Na kama ni hivyo, I don't know why we still pay taxes to them, to the government. Because hiyo bunduki polisi wamebeba ni ushuru wetu. Na hiyo risasi ni ushuru wetu. Na hiyo uniform wamevaa ni ushuru wetu na mshahara yao ni ushuru wetu. So as police, why are you partisan? Why are you being used by politicians? Because mimi nilifika Bomas. Nilipofika kwa gate, askari ndio walinizuia kuingia. Na hawakunizuia ati huko kuna shida usiingie. Utapatana na shida. Walikuwa wananizuia as morara nisiingie. When I managed to go in, nilipita milango tatu za Bomas kama sifunguliwi. Mlango ya kwanza, wakani block. They didn't open for me. Mlango ya pili, wakani block. They didn't open for me. Mlango ya tatu, they didn't open for me. Actually, I blame myself for not seeing the red flags. Mimi nasema, hata kama tunasema walifanya makosa, hata mimi, I should have seen that there was something. Yeah, I should have seen the red flag. But anyway, when I got in Naivurugi Kazuka, there were more than 100 police officers in Bomas on that day, outside. I don't know why they didn't do anything, why they didn't come in to quell the chaos, because I didn't go in with any group. Nilienda peke yangu. Ningeingia na group, ningesema group mbili zimepigana. But I went alone. Na watu walinipiga sio wananchi. It's not the public. The public in fact were demanding nipewe microphone. TJ Kajwanga kikataa nisipewe niongee. Watu waliniattack, walikuja specifically kutoka nyuma ya dais ya TJ Kajwanga. Na TJ Kajwanga ndiye alipoint na hata alincite TV wakisikia na kila Mkenya akisikia na hata aliongea kwa Kijaluo. The question is, kama ilikuwa shida yangu na Wajaluo, my first rally ni mawe kufanya Kenya ni Kondele. Mbona siku pigwa mawe Kondele? I believe the Luo people are very peaceful loving. It's just a few people want to intentionally and specifically give them a bad name. Mi nataka kusema mi mambo ya ukabila, I'm beyond it. And I'm not going to participate kwa mambo ya ukabila. Na mambo ya political violence, I'm not going to participate. Si ati nimeshindwa ama sina uwezo ya kumobilize for political violence, but if we play by the rules that these people are playing, then how are we better than them? I, as Morara Kebaso, I'm trying to groom and bring up myself as an alternative young leader, and not just me alone, but I'm trying to inspire other young leaders to join me in the INJECT party. INJECT stands for Inclusion of National Justice, Economic and Civic Transformation. So, I even want other young leaders to also join me. But when these young leaders join me, they'll be asking, what is the philosophy of this party? What do we stand for? Nyinyi pia, are you violent like ODM? Do you stand for beating up people and injuring them and so on? And you know. And I'll be telling them, no, we don't stand for violence. We just want a better Kenya. Right? So hiyo kitu ilifanyika ni tendo la aibu kwa hiyo chama na kwa wanachama wake na hata kwa viongozi wao. The police have refused to take any action. Ni sawa. As police, hivyo vile mnafanya, sijali, it will come to bite you one day. As police, when you refuse to be independent, you know, you can go to my Twitter, investigate me for a tweet I made about David Langat and arrest me mnizungusha police station kama tano. Unajua walinitoa Kiamba police station, walinitoa Nairobi area police station, police headquarters, wakanipeleka DC headquarters, wakanipeleka Kiamba, wakanipeleka Ruiru, wakanipeleka Thika, ni wakanipeleka Kamkunji. If you can do all that because of a tweet which David Langat never complained. But you cannot do this for violence that has been seen. Yet the work of the police is to protect life and property. So if you don't care about my life, you as police, why don't you care about the property that was destroyed? Anyway, ni sawa. Hivyo vile mnafanya, apandacho mtu atavuna. Atavuna tu hiyo. Once the police become partisan and start playing for politicians and working as errands for politicians, they will reap what they sow. Now, my intention for going to Bomas, I could have said this yesterday, but as I've told you during the family meeting, nilikuwa na a lot of dizziness because of medication, but right now I'm better. I have injuries on the neck and on the back of the head and on my leg, but let's just say I'm good. Niko sawa. Niko sawa. God has kept me safe. I was not paralyzed. I didn't receive a permanent injury. I was treated at the Nairobi hospital. But when I realized that the media has realized that I'm at Nairobi hospital, I shifted to another hospital so that I can be treated. Wamenifanyia scan ya kichwa, ya shingo. They've treated me well. Na niko sawa. I'm back to work. And the work is this. The work is hii impeachment ya Honorable Rigathi Gachagua should not be a tribal affair. Na mimi nimejaribu sana to ensure it's not a tribal affair. Kwa sababu kuna vile alikuwa ameanza kupata sympathy ya watu wa Mount Kenya. Nataka kushukuru watu wa Mount Kenya for saying kufa gari kufa dereva, because watu wa Mount Kenya wamekuwa loud sana kwa hiyo maneno. You know, Mount Kenya in itself has 4 to 5 million votes, which means if change is going to come to Kenya, especially through the ballot, it has to begin in Mount Kenya because they have a lot of votes. They should first champion or leaders toward that change. And that change is not Rigathi Gachagua. Because wakati mnamuonea huruma, mnasema, oh, huyu ni mtu wetu anapigwa, you are making a presidential candidate. You are giving someone influence. And this person is going to use this influence. Atafanya vitu mbili. Either atauzia William Ruto, so watazameana waseme ile ilikuwa mambo ya shetani, ni Raila ndiye aliingia kwa serikali akavuruga, tusame. He will sell the influence you've given him to William Ruto, or he'll run for president himself, na mkimchagua mtakuwa mmeruka from the frying pan to the fire. We want change in Kenya, and we want to change away from corruption. Every single thing Kenyans are talking about that has a problem, I, Morara, I want to tell you that the problem is corruption. If you look at the healthcare sector, the reason it has failed completely is because of state capture and corruption. People are thinking about making money. Ni kuiba pesa ya medical equipment, ni kuiba pesa ya madawa, ni madaktari kujaribu kudivert wagonjwa to private clinics. It's just corruption ndio imeua hiyo sector. If you come to education, it is corruption that has killed the sector. You know, university is trying to make money in unscrupulous ways. Yeah. Help trying to do this and that. Funding of universities, you know, money being stolen through funding of universities. You know, payroll, the role of students as fake students, the role of schools as fake schools. Textbooks, you know, is a big procurement scandal. This is what has killed the key sectors of our country. Corruption, corruption, corruption. If you deal with corruption, you solve 90% of the problems in Kenya. And that is why my message has always been against corruption. The reason they brought the impeachment motion against Rigathi Gachagua is so that we divert our attention. Tuache kufikiria Adani, tuache kufikiria Chief, tuache kufikiria vile wagonjwa wanakufa hospitalini, tuache kufikiria vile corruption imetuumiza, barabara ni mbaya, wananchi wanaumia, uchumi ni mbaya, people are not making money, businesses are closing, you know, industries are closing, watu wamepoteza majob, wenye wako na majobu wako overtaxed, they didn't want us to focus on this issue. They wanted us to focus on something else. Na nilipo realize kwamba siwezi kudivert your attention because, you know, the government, some of these people own media houses and the government advertises on media houses. So media houses wameshikwa mahali so that if they don't broadcast what these people want, then they don't get government tenders to advertise. And it's millions and billions of money. So because of that, the media has made it a, you know, a national issue. Not that it has become a national issue, nikasema hivi, let's also make it our business. Wacha tuingie kwa hiyo national issue, to participate kwa hiyo mambo ya impeachment. Na participation yetu ni gani? Let's both of them go. Rigathi Gachagua is not better for Kenya. I mean, there's no doubt that Rigathi Gachagua is corrupt. There's no doubt that he's tribal. There's no doubt that he's incompetent. There's no doubt that he sabotages the president. You know, I don't like President William Ruto. I don't like him. But one of us, me or you who is watching this video, one day you will be a president. You can't have a deputy sabotaging you all the time. At Yuko Nairobi, yeah, in a whole press conference Mombasa, talking about the NIS, a very sensitive national security organ, of which vitu kama hizo ni vitu za kuongewa kwa boardroom. When you are a deputy president, your job is to deputize the president. If you feel you can no longer be a deputy president, talk. Resign and come out here and do politics. So even if I hate or dislike William Ruto or don't like him as a president because he's a liar, he likes lying and corrupt and all these things, I don't support the disrespect of our president by a deputy president. That I don't support because a deputy president's work is to deputize. He's behaving like an opposition leader and we are here. Hey, akianza sasa kufanya opposition within government, sisi tufanya kazi gani? And if Rigathi Gachagua has decided to be an opposition leader, it's okay. Let him tell us the truth. He says he's a truthful man. Atuambie the truth about Adani. Atuambie the truth about Shiv. Atuambie the truth about university funding model. Atuambie the truth about finance bill. Atuambie the truth about the bribing of members of parliament. Atuambie the truth about corruption, about line 5, petroleum, 40 billion for the petroleum line 5 from, you know, Mombasa to Nairobi. Atuambia about 12 billion loss from treasury. Atuambia about 15 billion za e-citizens zenye zimepotea. Atuambia ama zijulikani kama ziko ama hakuna. Atuambia about 400 million ya Kericho Green Stadium ya Madaraka Day last year. Let him tell us the truth. They've already told us how Gachagua is corrupt. Why is he not willing to tell us how they are corrupt? So iko kitu hapo. So me, I don't mind if he is impeached. I don't mind. It's good riddance. It's one bad person down. And it's good because it will set a precedent that a deputy president or a president can be impeached. But the reason we are saying impeach both is because we want to remove the tribal factor from that equation. So that it's not about tribalism anymore. It's about accountability. It's about leaders being accountable. As Morara, I'll continue to champion for the rights of Kenyans. Not because of permission or because lazima munishabikie or because of anything, but because this is a personal decision that comes from inside my heart. And I will not do it even for money or for anything. I'll do it because I believe in it. And those who believe in me can continue supporting me. And lastly, there's been this conversation about leaderless and individualism. And what I can say is that, tusijidanganye, in Kenya, we have leaders who have been born young and middle class, middle age and old. There are leaders of integrity. Stop stepping on those leaders. Ati mtu akikama hapo mnasema, oh, you're being individualistic, you want to personalize the movement, you want to be, yes, we are leaders. That's why the media keeps calling us activists, because it doesn't want to call us leaders, because they don't want us to be leaders. These people are only afraid when we plan to take leadership. Otherwise, they don't care when we call them corrupt. They know they are corrupt, and they know that their electorate knows that they are corrupt and will still elect them as corrupt. So what do? As Kenyans, hizi shida zote tuko nazo, hatuwezi fanya maandamano ya Adani, tufanye maandamano ya agricultural bill, tufanye maandamano ya hii bill ingine wameleta ya kuextend term limit, tufanye maandamano ya IBC. Let's combine all those issues into one. Ruto and Gachagua must go. That one, regime change. Let's combine all our issues, regime change. Otherwise, I'll be having more conversations with you. I'm back in circulation, and I hope the Lord will go before us. Now, the other truth is that in my team, the NIS placed a mall a long time ago. You know, Quinn. I have a mole on my team. Because when I got an accident in Embu, for me, nilikataza wa Kenya, no, don't speculate. Nilikataza wa Kenya, apana, mwache kusema your accident was planned. Eh? Accidents happen, and this has happened. But later, I realized Kenyans were not wrong to be paranoid or to be suspicious. Kenyans were actually right to be suspicious, and I was wrong not to be suspicious. Because the car that did an accident was not owned by an individual, it's owned by a company. And when you search the CR12 for that company in the register of companies and you check the directors, it's a dead end. The driver is somebody we've looked for, and we've not found him to date. Gari hata iko huko inaitwa ni Mukurweini police station. What is that place? Yes. To date, we've not found the driver. Yeah? Now, when I was arrested, there's a call that was made from this office around this building. And that call was made to DCI that I'm here. Somebody was called here, akaulizwa boss ako ye. Aliposema ako, that person called DCI. When DCI came to this office for an arrest, they didn't guess. They didn't look for my office. Remember, this compound is so big with so many offices. But they didn't look for my office. They came straight to my office as if they already had the plan and layout of the building. When bombers happened, okay, when I was arrested, this mall was not there. So whenever bad things happen, hakuangi. Anywhere near. Bomas, this person is a very close person in my team and should have been at Bomas because kama naenda Bomas na team yangu imenijoin. Mbona ya na miss na kwake ni karibu na Bomas. Mbona alikuja huku kwa ofisi mahali siko badala aende Bomas mahali ni karibu na hata mahali ya naishi. So the NIS placed a person in my team a long time ago. When you research this person's history, you are not able to know which primary school they went to, secondary school. They wiped their profile clean. And the best way to hoodwink Kenyans has been, this person pretends, you know, to criticize the government, to say bad things, to you know, expose projects so that we can trust this person. There's been an attempt to poison my food. And I'm thankful to God that it didn't happen. Na kama singejua that we have a mole, I think by now I would be dead. But I'm grateful to God and to the various Kenyans who've been sending me information, telling me be careful about this person. And I have now become very serious about my security. And now I have an advanced intelligence team that goes to the ground before I go to a public event and does, you know, just checking what is the feeling among, you know. For example, in Bomas, you know, I walked into a public event which was organized by ODM and which people had been mobilized and paid money through in buses and where there were goons paid waiting for me because I had said I'm going to Bomas. I've never been attacked anywhere in Kenya because I've never said I'm going to this place. Sijai sema leo naenda Embu, ama leo naenda Githurai, ama leo naenda Kitengela, ama leo naenda Moloto Bomet. I've never said it. Hata nikisemanga na semanga tu, I'll be in Rift Valley generally. But because these people knew I'm specifically coming to, you know, KICC, which later turned to Bomas, they planned very well kuniua, but they didn't succeed. Because God is good, and because there's a mission. God has given me a mission, and I must complete it. That's why he has kept me alive. So from now on, Kenyans, wakati mnaangalia timu yangu na kuna mtu mnajua na mnajua ni mbaya, please don't keep quiet. Always raise alarm. I've started vetting every member of my team, where they went to school, what they did, who they are, why they are here, what they do for a living, what they are doing. but wa Kenya mnisaidie kwa hiyo mambo, so that tusikue na moles kwa team yetu. There is also another incident that I was about to forget. When I was attacked at Bomas, I went to the hospital. When I went to the hospital, I was treated, but wind got to the media and other people that I'm at Nairobi Hospital, so I left the hospital. I came to this office to pick something before I go to the next hospital, so nilikuwa nasaidiwa na watu wangu. Na nilipofika hapa kwa ofisi, I got information from three different sources that I'll be arrested. And the reason I was supposed to be arrested on Friday was the police were looking for someone to blame for what happened at Bomas. They were saying, let's blame the chaos on Morara. But me, I was asking, but Morara came alone. In fact, at the door, he was only allowed to enter with one guard. So how do you blame it on him? But the police wanted actually to arrest me on Friday and blame the chaos on Bomas on me. So because of that planned arrest, I decided to set a trap for the police. Because I knew they are tracking my phones, I said, ntawacha simu zangu hapa, I'll go without a phone. Let's see whether the police will come. And the police never came. Because their mole, the NIS mole inside my team, told them ameondoka msikuje. This only goes a long way in showing Kenyans that it's no longer business as usual. My life is actually in danger and I need to be more careful than I've been. Now, the reason I had not beefed up my security, you know, some Kenyans have been saying, sasa wewe Morara kwani unatembea kama Mkenya wa kawaida, kwa nini usi beef up security? Why are you failing? But security is expensive. Security is not cheap. Let's say, you know, hypothetically speaking, let's say you pay one security guard, say 20 or 25,000, for example. Just an example. How many would you need to guard the residents, to guard you, and how will you afford that cost every month? So, hapa ndo inafikanga viongozi wananunuliwa na William Ruto ama na some billionaires. You find that somebody is actually being supported by NGOs that have an interest, or foreign governments that have an interest, or some billionaires that have an interest, because you are not able to afford basic security. But mimi nitachangisha. Mtachangisha wa Kenya, kila Mkenya akinitumia 10 bob, 10 bob, thao, thao mbili, so moja, miatano. I believe I'll be able to beef up my security and it will be well. So, whatever you can spare, I'll be really appreciative to Kenyans, whatever they can spare to support me in beefing up my security. But otherwise, me, what I can promise Kenyans ni kwamba siwezi nunuliwa. There are stories of people who say, huyu ni project, huyu ni project. Maybe they themselves who are saying, huyu ni project, they are the project. Labda wao wenyewe is their project. But I don't think it's fair or good to call someone a project when you don't know them in person, you don't know their history, you don't know where they came from. Me, I come from a family history of fighters. People believe in something, people are principled. So hatufanani, sio sisi wote ununuliwa, sio sisi wote ukuanga project za watu. There are some of us who actually fight for change because we believe in it. So, hiyo kitu ya kukua na mole ilini hurt sana, sana. But, ndivyo ilivyo. Unajua sikuwa na political experience vizuri, but sunaona I'm gaining and I'm learning quickly. So, hata kama nilifanya hiyo makosa ya kuovertrust watu, kuenda mahali bila intelligence, ni ukweli nilifanya makosa and I'm sorry. I apologize to all Kenyans kwamba hapo niliteleza, lakini it will not happen again. I will be more careful this time. And I'll continue fighting for what we believe in together. Sitawai wa disappoint na sitawai wa chilia. I'll keep doing the Vampire Diaries. I'll keep doing civic education. I'll not stop. Because when I stop, the enemy wins. And the enemy should not win.